This week, we commemorate the Yahrzeit of Rabbi Moshe Isserles, known popularly by the acronym of his name, the Rema, an extremely influential figure from the 16th century. He unified much of world Jewry under a single halachic banner, which allowed for some levels of flexibility for ethnic orientation, but at the same time really established the ascendancy of Polish Jewry for the next five centuries. Here is a colorized portrait of the Rema based on an artistic rendition. His family background was quite significant. He was a descendant of some of the great scholars of Poland and had married into a very significant family in Poland as well. He is known for his tremendously broad approach to many different areas of human endeavor, including philosophy and Kabbalah, besides his halakhic insights. And he is known as the Polish Maimonides because of this kind of breadth of knowledge represents his overarching worldview. He was born into a very wealthy family, and although he suffered a tremendous loss when he was quite young, his wife died at the age of 20, he nevertheless translated many of his personal difficulties into his Torah scholarship. For example, he built a synagogue in his wife's name, which stands to this day, and also he established a yeshiva and supported the students with his own funds. He later remarried and had several children as well. His most significant contribution to world Jewry is undoubtedly a magisterial commentary on the Shulchan Aruch called the Mapa, or tablecloth. This in itself is kind of a tongue-in-cheek reference to the fact that the great code of Jewish law had the title Shulchan Aruch, authored by Rabbi Yosef Karo, a contemporary of the Rema. And Shulchan Aruch means basically the prepared table. So in response to the prepared table, Rabbi Moshe Isserles wrote the Mapa, or the tablecloth, which, as it were, covers over the Shulchan Aruch. Rabbi Moshe Isserles was in contact with Rabbi Yosef Karo and was actually involved in a halachic project of a very similar nature. But when he got a sense of what Rabbi Yosef Karo was doing with the Shulchan Aruch, he decided to adapt his own project to a unique commentary on the Shulchan Aruch, which had tremendous significance. Here's a page of a more contemporary printing of the Shulchan Aruch. This is from the volume Eben HaEzer. And if we zoom in to the central portion here, I apologize for the poor digitization, but I'll be able to make the point, I hope, with this. One of the unusual ways in which the Rema's work, the Mapa, was utilized is that beginning in the 1570s, it was printed as an interlinear commentary with the Shulchan Aruch, rather than being kind of like, if we go back one slide here, rather than being one of the Nosei Kalim, the armor bearer, so to speak, that surrounds the central page. It was actually printed right in the very central text. Here, I'll show you what I mean. If you look at this arrow, this points to the larger block print, the so-called Ksav Ashuris, the traditional square printing of the Hebrew text, and these are the words of Rav Yosef Karo, known as the Mechaber, or the author. Down here, in italicized text, popularly known as Rashi's script, is the commentary of Rav Moshe Isserles, the Rema. Printed together like this, they represent a profound unification of the largely Sephardic-centric opinions of the Shulchan Aruch with the Ashkenazi Polish opinions of the Rema. And so by reading them together in the same code, it suddenly made the Shulchan Aruch perhaps one of the most, it made it the most authoritative code that had ever been written, and of course it has endured to this day as the single most significant halachic code that is binding on Jews around the world. One of the other aspects of the Rema's work is that, you know, in the context of the Mapa, in which he is distinguishing the Polish customs from the Sephardic customs, he actually alienated many German readers. And quite a few rabbis in Germany were a little upset with the production of the Mapa because it represented Polish customs rather than German ones, and they actually advanced against the Mapa some of the same criticisms that Maimonides had faced. For example, his code was simply so good that people might be tended not to rely on live rabbis and go instead to books to find out how they were supposed to behave. These criticisms, of course, were largely ignored, and time demonstrated the lasting value of the work of the Rema. And it has remained an extremely influential text, even among Sephardim, who generally would have otherwise paid attention to the Shulchan Aruch alone. His grave, shown here in Krakow, was a site of pilgrimage for Polish Jews right up until the Holocaust, and perhaps maybe, you know, resurrected once again as a pilgrimage site. And at his grave, many are known to remark that from Moses until Moses, there was no one like Moses. This is a paraphrase of a reference originally to Moses Maimonides and Moses of the Torah, but in many ways it was applied to Rabbi Moshe Isserles as well for his outstanding achievement and contribution to world Jewry.